Good evening, everyone. Myself, Ashu Sharma. Today, we will see some of the commands that we use in SQLite and its syntax. It's very important topic that we are going to use further when we will create database and use some of these commands over there. So start with next slide. That SQLite syntax, when we talk about, it's a unique set of rules and guidelines. Following, you can say, syntax for SQLite that we will see how to just write those syntax and semantics over there. One thing is there that case sensitivity. Case sensitivity, SQLite is not case sensitive, but there are some commands which are case sensitive. Suppose, for example, GLOB, globe operator, and GLOB in small letters have different meaning in SQLite statements. So when we talk about the SQLite GLOB, globe operator, it is used to match only the text values against a pattern. And if the search expression can be matched to the pattern expression, the globe operator will return true. It means one in a Boolean. It's a like operator, globe is case sensitive one, and it follows syntax of that Unix for specifying the wildcards. So globe is something in which we are going to match to search that expression can be matched with the pattern expression. And if it is true, it will return definitely one. So there are certain exceptions where we can say it's follow case sensitivity, or some of the cases that it doesn't follow case sensitivity. Next is about the comments. Comments are used to add more readability in your SQLite code. Comments cannot be nested. Comments begin with the two consecutive double quotes characters, and sometimes it also appears as slash and extend up to including the next slash character pair. So these are different ways of finding those comments once we work with the SQLite. Now move to the next slide. We have some syntax and semantics of the concept of some of these commands. All the SQLite statement is started with any of the keywords like select, you can say insert, update, delete, alter, drop, and many more. All the statements will end with a semicolon. So once we talk about the analyze statement, generally we consider it's a command that gathers the statistics about the tables and the indices, and the collected information in internal tables of the database, where the query optimizer can access the information and use it to help make better query planning as with respect to the choices. If no arguments are given, all attached database are analyzed. So as we see, there is a syntax analyze, follow up with this semicolon, then analyze space database name semicolon, or you may write as analyze space database name dot table name. So analyze commands gathers statistics information about the table and indices, and store the collected information in internal tables of the database, where the query optimizer can access the information and use it for the better query planning. So we have to make with the query execution planning. So it's important over there. When do we have this analyze concept? Now move to the next, that SQLite and oblique or clause. Here we have select. Select is always there with where. So select statement is used to fetch the data from a SQLite database table, which returns data in the form of a result table. So here we have select column 1, comma column 2, and so on. From table name, this is the table name where condition 1 and or oblique or condition 2. So once this condition is true, definitely it returns certain results with respect to the given condition. So these result tables are also called result sets. So here we have to select certain columns from the given table and here is certain conditions with respect to satisfied condition, we will have that results of different columns, and these results as a combined table, you can say it's a result sets. So this is the way that SQLite select statement work. Now move to the next slide. Here we have the concept of, you can say, SQLite alter table statement. So syntax is alter table, then table name, add column, and then the column definition. Follow up with semicolon. So by using the SQLite alter table statement, you can perform two actions. Either you may rename like this a table, or SQLite alter table adding a new column, add column to a table. So two actions may perform. One action is to rename a table, or to perform this adding a new column to a table. So this is the syntax: alter table, table name, rename to new table name. So this is the way you may use this alter table statement. Now the new column cannot have a unique or primary key constraint. You may have this, once we use this alter table statement, the new column cannot have a unique or primary key constraint. If the new column has a not null constraint, you must specify a default value for the column other than a null value. So you have to specify a default value for the column which cannot be a null value. So other than a null value. So this is that important when we use this alter table statement. Now move to the next that is statement, which is SQLite attach database statement. Here is a syntax: attach database name as alias name. Now here we have, once we try to attach an additional database to the current database, connections, you use the attach database statement, and as follows, as we have this syntax, and you will have to use this that statement which is associates the database file with the file name with the current database. So connections under the logical database name as such follows. So firstly you have this attached database, then database name, as you have to give that alias name for that also. So this is that way you use this attached database statement. Now the concept that begins with that SQLite begin transaction statement. So here begin, follow up with the semicolon, or begin exclusive transaction. So by default, SQLite operates in auto commit mode. It means that for each command, SQLite starts, processes, and commits the transaction automatically. So once we say the auto commit mode, it means that for each command, SQLite starts, process, and commits the transaction automatically. To start a transaction explicitly, you can use various commands like begin transaction command, like begin exclusive transaction. So you may use these command statement. Now here we have that SQLite Pittman clause. So here we have select column 1, column 2, and so on, column n, from the given table name, and where column name between value 1 and value 2. SQLite commit statement and commit. So commit is always there once we have the complete transaction, so that it makes that database consistent. It's very, very important. Now till this we have covered some of these statements like analyze, select, and in the next slide we have covered this alter table statement, then attach database statements, and begin transaction statements, and between clause. So from this session we have covered all these statements, and in the later sessions of this series of SQLite we will cover all of these commands together. So it is very, very interesting series of SQLite, and it's very lightweight to use. So I personally suggest you do it at home and practice on your systems. It's very easy to configure on your systems. In the next session, we will cover this create index, create unique, and some more statements that we generally used in SQLite. So thank you very much for being with me in this session. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so you may get notification of latest video. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Thank you.